Finally, we get some explosions. More like two.
In the days of darkness, when there is no hope for light, the only thing you can do is try and survive.
Escape from L.A. The 1996 sequel to a film that is 15 years older yet is directed by the same master, John Carpenter. The plot. It is beat for beat the same as the first. Just name the differences. Snake Plissken is sent into L.A. to retrieve a black boxy and kill the president's daughter. Now he must figure out what to do in 10 hours or a deadly virus will overtake his body and kill him. Now, Kurt Russell and Deborah Hill pleaded for John to make a sequel to Escape from New York since the mid-80s, and even a script was written. Only did he when the Los Angeles earthquake happened and it gave him an idea. The story is that LA is separated from the US and is now a place for criminals, outlaws, and people who just committed the smallest of crimes. It would have worked had it been more different. There are tons of twists and turns that deviate from the first film, but they are all still the same concept. With the addition of holograms, it answered more questions than make problems for the film. There are tons of characters in this movie. Kurt Russell owns the role of Snake Plissken, and he's gone on record saying that this is his favorite character he's ever done. I will say he's got some great one-liners in this film. He may even be better than he was in the original. Bruce Campbell has a small cameo as a plastic surgeon, which leads to a really freaky scene. Steve Buscemi plays a weasel of a character and knows the area like the back of his hand. Peter Fonda plays a surfer dude, which leads to some god-awful CGI. Which leads me to the gore, the effects. There is not too much blood in here at all. The CG work is god-awful though. It's quite surprising because the film did have a decent budget of $50 million. That's not too far off the first Jurassic Park, which came out only 3 years prior. I can only chalk it up to two things. No time to work on the effects, or a poor studio who can't do amazing effects. Either way, the CGI is a big damper on this movie. Even with the ridiculous scenes such as the basketball challenge and surfing the tsunami, it can't even be so bad it's good because everything is so serious. Green screen gone bad is a good way to describe it. The motion picture soundtrack, the one saving grace of this film, is the updated music. The theme is more energetic than the first film's, and we even get some white zombie on there. I might actually prefer it over the original's motion picture soundtrack, but that's up for debate because the original's music fit better. Wow, what the hell happened? It made half its money back and was a financial and critical flop. I can see why. This is just bad cheese, and while it is rewatchable, I wouldn't recommend it to the casual moviegoer. Overall, I give Escape from L.A. a 2 out of 5. Lion Brian Gatto, host of Horror Show Entertainment. Make sure to like my Facebook page in the description below and leave comments and subscribe.